So I want to give a brief overview of this releasing technique. The analogy is, imagine that this is our feelings, our emotions. And this is our gut, or our awareness, or our consciousness. And now, this is what's happening a lot of the times. We're holding on very tightly in our awareness, in our consciousness, to the feeling. I'm squeezing pretty tight and it's uncomfortable. It doesn't really feel good. But if you were to do it continuously for a while, it starts to become sort of normalized. You don't even realize it. It just becomes a kind of a natural state. And so in this state, obviously it's impossible to let the feeling go because the feeling has essentially become us. It's attached. And you even notice this in the way we tend to language things. Instead of saying, "I feel sad," we say, "I am sad." Instead of saying, "I feel angry," we say, "I am angry." So "I am" is much different. This is what "I am" looks like. "I feel sad" looks like this, right? It's like there's the feeling and there's my awareness, but it's not attached. I mean, it's just sort of shown up there. It's not going to be there forever. No feeling or emotion is. And so, clinging, attaching to the feeling, impossible to let go. But, when we can loosen the grip, the letting go is completely natural. And so this process is a way of sort of encouraging that. It's deceptively simple, but as I found over the years, all the great techniques are always the simplest and most elegant. So I encourage you to give it a try, see what you think. Try it for a few weeks. I've had some very impressive results with this technique. It's based on the work of Lester Levinson, who had a pretty interesting story. And I had the opportunity to work with one of his colleagues many years ago. So that's how I learned the technique. So let me know how it goes.